Hi, this video tutorial will guide you through the process of building the VPET application for Windows and Android. Before we start, make sure that you use Unity version 5.37, which you can access through the Unity 3D archives. You will need the latest Tango SDK in case you're building for a Tango device. The version is Caporales from January. And to start, please go to our GitHub page of VPET and start a clean checkout of that project. So in the GitHub repository, you can find the basic documentation, which just recently got a new section with tutorials. There's one posted where Katana's use with VPET is explained a bit more in detail. From here, you can also access the basic information about the three VPET components, a Unity client application, the one that we're gonna build now, the scene distribution plugin, and the synchronization server. From here, you can also access some more detailed information about the VPET Unity client. So let's get started. We'll open Unity version 5.37 and we're gonna start a new project. We'll call it VPET Dev for now. Gonna ignore the update information and we'll import a custom package that you can find in your repository checkout VPET Unity package. And we're gonna import just with the default settings. And in the VPET folder under scenes, start your VPET client scene and press play. Your screen should look something like this. Start with a splash screen and then you get some basic settings. You can check the load from cache, hit load and nothing will happen. That's because we have not added a cache file so far. We'll do that for now. It's a cached scene here. We go into our VPET dev. Assets, resources, VPET, scene dumps, add this cache file, give it another try. And then we can see that the default San Miguel scene that we use within our project is loaded from cache. So that's basically it for Windows. All you need to do is to switch to x86-64 as architecture, and then you can build your Windows application. We'll do that for now. Okay, so I got my build copied to the surface where I can start this application. And after the splash screen, you'll see the settings menu where you can connect to the scene distribution and the synchronization server. In our case, we're loading a cached scene, the San Miguel scene. And as you can see, I can choose from some predefined camera locations and use the gyro to scout into the scene. You can turn off the gyro and then start interacting with objects in the scene. And move that over here, maybe link it to the camera and position it elsewhere. And same applies for lights. You can move move those around. And change, for instance, the light color or intensity. So that's basically it for the Windows build. Okay, up next, I'll show you how to build for Android, and more particularly, we're gonna build for a Tango device to make use of inside-out tracking. So Unity right now is in exactly the same state as we left it when we did our Windows build. So first thing we'll do is to bring up the build settings and switch over to Android, switch the platform. So that takes a second. In some cases, you might also be prompted with dialogue to point to the latest JDK and Android SDK. Okay, now close that dialogue, and next we're gonna import another package, and that is going to be the latest Tango SDK, Caporales in that case. So gonna just import the default settings. And then all you need to do is make sure that your Tango manager is activated as well as the Tango object. Open your player settings and make sure that your scripting defined symbol has this string entered, use underscore tango, all in capital. And that's basically it. Okay, so to build the Android version of your VPET application, and in particular here for the Google Tango device, just hit build and run, and you can override the version that I created earlier, and it will take a few moments for the application to build and upload it to your device. And here you can see it looks pretty much like the Windows build with an additional option for an augmented reality view. You also have a slider for the Tango scale, which can intensify the distances that you move in 3D space. And we load the cached scene, which looks identical to the one we just had on the Windows device. And here you can see, in addition to the gyros, I can also use the positional tracking to scout and navigate in 3D space. Can turn on and off those gyros and perform the same actions as you saw on the Windows build. Can also animate these objects, which is takes a bit more time to explain that, so I won't go into this now, but you can see that it's pretty simple and intuitive to perform these actions. And if you have the full system set up with your synchronization server, all these changes to your virtual scene are reflected back to your central production system. That's basically it. It's quite simple to build for both Windows and Android. Just make sure that you use the right Unity and Tango SDK versions. Follow the instructions, and if there's any questions, don't hesitate to contact us. Thanks. Okay, we'd also like to cover a new device that we just got recently access to. This is a Lenovo Fab 2 Pro, and also supports the Tango platform for inside-out tracking. So I'll quickly show you how to build for that device. So in Unity, in your player settings first, set your Android version to 6.0, and then go to the main camera object and check this Tango build for Lenovo Fab 2 checkbox and hit build and run. So maybe a few things to add in the end about the building for the Tango devices. So make sure that you've updated the Google Tango core on your device, and also in these examples of the video cast, I'm using a cached scene. There's functionality to write out a cached scene, but unfortunately, we cannot dispute the scene that we're referring to. If you want to have access to this scene, then you should go to the DreamSpace download page, and there is an email address where you can ask for access of those assets, and very likely you will be granted access to those. And you can use those to create your own cache, or you use Katana to build up a scene from scratch, and then you can use the VPET tools to write out your own cache. Yeah, that's basically it.